Hi students, I am Ashwin Anand from Chathangulam MBA College, Palakkad. In this video, I will be taking an orientation class on quantitative techniques. So, first we will look at the various learning objectives of this class. First is the meaning of quantitative techniques. Next, we will be discussing the decision-making basics. And the third one we will be discussing is the relevance of quantitative techniques in business decision making. And the fourth point we'll be discussing is the classification of quantitative techniques. And the last point will be the various quantitative tools available for decision making. So let's see the definition of quantitative techniques. I have already written in the board. I'll just read it out. It can be defined as a collection of mathematical and statistical tools that are used to provide powerful means of analysis using quantitative data for effective decision making in business. So this is the definition of quantitative techniques. The techniques involves systematic and scientific method for solving complex problems for taking effective business decisions. It involves use of symbols, numbers and mathematical expressions and other elements of quantitative techniques and serve as a supplement intuition of the decision maker. These tools helps in business in optimum utilization of limited resources. So next we will be looking into decision making basics. Decision making pervades all aspects of business. The verb decide has been derived from the Latin prefix de and the word gets meaning off and to cut respectively. This led to the origin of the word decido or deciduous, referring to those plants the leaves of which fall in the autumn. The other word derived from it is decide, that means taking the plunge, suggesting the meaning of in which making a wrong decision provokes the fear of falling. Next we will see decision making process. So decision-making process is a systematic process involving several steps such as identifying the problem or issue, identifying decision criteria, generating alternatives, evaluating and choosing an alternative, implementing the decision alternative, and finally evaluating if the decision alternative was effective or not. Let's take an example. If an organization is deciding to buy laptops for its 500 employees, then it needs to first find out why these laptops are needed, then the kind of configuration they require, and the price, the quality, the service warranties that different vendors will be charging, then evaluating a set of vendors, and then take a decision to order from a vendor. So next we will be seeing role of intuition in decision making. Right, so when a manager makes a decision based on experience, feelings or accumulated judgments, we may say that he or she is making a decision based on intuitions. Right, so this is the meaning of intuition. So we can see that there are different types of intuitions. First one is based on experience based intuition. And the second one is affect initiated decisions. What is affect initiated decisions? It is intuition that is based on feelings or emotion based, right? And the third one is cognitive based decisions. These are based on skills and knowledge of a decision maker. That is the cognitive based decisions. And the fourth one is the subconscious mental processing. And the fifth one is the value or ethics based decisions. So these are the five different types of intuitions we come to know. So next is the types of decisions. There are basically two types of decision. One is structured and programmed decisions and the other one is unstructured and non-programmed decisions. So when a problem are routine in nature, that is they are simple and straightforward, we call them structured and programmed decisions. We solve them by creating rules, policies and procedures in the organization. But if a problem is unique and complex, then we need to think out of the box, right? So which are called as unstructured and non-programmed decisions. So next we will see conditions under which decision making is done, right? So the first condition is decision making under certainty. The manager makes most accurate decisions as he is aware of the outcome of every action beforehand. This is one of the most desirable and ideal conditions, but in real life we don't find these kind of situations quite often. So this is the decision making under certainty. Next one is the decision making under risk. The manager, in this case, the manager is not at all aware of all possible outcomes of his choice of alternatives. He is not even in a position to make some probable outcomes. The alternatives are chosen by a manager's intuition, judgment, or his personal psychological orientation. And the next type of decision making is the decision making under uncertainty. In this case, the decision maker is unable to estimate the likelihood of certain outcomes. Under risk, manager utilizes his historical data from secondary sources or from his personal experiences and find probabilities to different alternatives. So this is the case of the three different decision makings we have given. So next we will see the decision making concept. There are basically two types of decision making concept. First one is the rational decision making and the next one is the non-rational decision making. So when a person makes logical and consistent choices to maximize the value, we call it rational decision. It is not practical to make rational decision always due to lack of information. More realistic approach to make decision is the concept of bounded rationality. As per the manager, makes decisions rationally but are limited or bounded by their ability to process information. It is not possible for managers to evaluate all information or all alternatives, and therefore managers makes satisfying decisions rather than that will maximize his or her gain. That is, they accept solutions that are good enough. So next we will see classification of quantitative techniques. Quantitative techniques can be classified into two. One is the mathematical technique and the other one is the statistical technique. So mathematical technique, these process quantitative data using mathematical principles to solve management problems, whereas in the statistical techniques, these use statistical tools used for analyzing data for better decision making. So next I will be discussing the different mathematical techniques as well as the different statistical techniques. So next we will see the different mathematical quantitative techniques, and the first one is the algebra. Next we have set theory, and next one is the permutation and combination, and the next we have matrix algebra, and next is the determinants and differential and integrations and differential equations. Next we have under mathematical quantitative techniques, we have different programming techniques that are linear programming, assignment and transportation models, dynamic programming and inventory control, then game theory, queuing theory, replacement models, simulations, decision theory, network programming, sequencing and quadratic programming. So next topic is the statistical concepts and techniques. So we will see different statistical concepts. First one is the basics of, first we will see seeing is the basics of statistics. Next what we will be seeing, the data classification, tabulation and presentation. And the next we will be seeing is the measure of central tendency. Then next is the measure of dispersion. Next is the probability and probability distribution. And next one is the sampling and sampling distribution. And next is the estimation theory. Then comes the hypothesis testing and decision making, which forms a essential component of the statistical concept, and the next one is the analysis of variance. We call it ANOVA. And the next is the correlation and regression analysis, and next is the forecasting using time series analysis, and the last one is the fundamentals of decision theory. So in this orientation class, we'll be discussing only the statistical concepts and techniques, which we'll be discussing in our later videos. Thank you.